Good afternoon, bhai. Good afternoon, good afternoon, good afternoon. Getting the voice? Once check, voice coming. Voice coming, bhai. Coming. Chalye, great. So, how's the life going? All good? Enjoying? मस्त बढ़िया ग्रेट सो हाउ इज द प्रिपरेशन गोइंग हाउ इज द प्रिपरेशन गोइंग वन चैप्टर इज ओवर इन ट्रैक वन वन चैप्टर ओवर इन ट्रैक टू रीडिंग समथिंग इन द हाउस Give some motivation. वाह बेटा वाह चल टेक टू मिनट्स एंड टेल यू समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग अबाउट मोटिवेशन एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ डबलेट एंड ट्रिपलेट नेटवर्क स्पेक्ट्रा बाय स्पिन क्वांटम नंबर दिस वॉज द क्वेश्चन आई आस्क्ड यू टू सर्च आई थिंक राइट डिड आई आस्क यू टू सर्च दिस क्वेश्चन ना या ग्रेट बिल्कुल सो द आंसर इज स्पिन क्वांटम नंबर ऑफ दैट क्वेश्चन करेक्ट है भाई सो टेल यू समथिंग अबाउट मोटिवेशन सो दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ मच मोटिवेशन यू नीड एंड हाउ फ्रीक्वेंटली यू नीड मोटिवेशन टू वर्क राइट सो आई एम अ केमिस्ट्री टीचर सो ऑब्वियसली द मोटिवेशन आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट विल बी केमिकली ओरिएंटेड बेटा हियर तो ओके यार Here, I don't think problem is there. I can once check if you want, but in my knowledge, problem is not there. No, bhai, problem is not there. No, that means your internet is weak, beta. That's why I cannot come to your house and check, na? That's your internet problem. Because here we are running the YouTube also, you can... It's going on YouTube means everything is okay. Then, bhai? So, yeah. About motivation, one thing should be very clear, bhai. You might feel little stressed, you might feel little demotivated also. And sometimes it will happen, not demotivated. After the exam, people feel demotivated. Generally, we feel boring. When we are doing the same thing again and again, it is very boring. Okay, bhai? Correct? So how many of you are in the boredom right now? How many of you are feeling bored now? Like that energy is not coming that you have to wake up every day and attend the classes regularly, complete your work every day. That feeling is not coming. Like you want to clear this exam, correct? But that work culture that we have to follow, that work culture, you are not able to follow properly. Who are there? Okay, one, two. Many will be there. Some are doing the acting of not saying it, but they are there. Correct? There, bilkul. Chaliye. So what time you woke up here today? At what time you woke up? Shamita, Niveta, Ashwak, what time you woke up today? 6, 5, 6, 6. ठीक है 5:30 ग्रेट डिड यू टेक योर ब्रेकफास्ट ब्रेकफास्ट टेकन आफ्टर वेकिंग अप व्हाट टाइम यू टुक द ब्रेकफास्ट व्हाट टाइम यू टुक द ब्रेकफास्ट 8:30 9 8:30 10:15 अच्छा राइट नाउ टेकन 9 ग्रेट 8:30 डिड यू मेक योर ब्रेकफास्ट हु मेड द ब्रेकफास्ट फॉर यू Mom, mother, mom, Ammi, mom, mummy. ठीक है सो एक्सेप्ट वन पर्सन सेड Zomato. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट हाँ नाउ कनिष्का नाउ चेंज फ्रॉम Zomato टू Swiggy. दैट मीन्स बिल्कुल बकवास आंसर गिवन नीदर सेम स्टूडेंट सेड Zomato ऑल्सो Swiggy ऑल्सो घोचू राम At least stick to one single app. Nahi sir, idli I ordered from Zomato and chutney came from Swiggy sir. And slap came running from the parents. Na like kahenge. Chaliye bhai. So now, you are saying your mother has cooked breakfast for you, correct? For most of you, your mother cooked the breakfast. Since when is your mother giving you breakfast? Since when? Every time means with since when? Since how many years? Since how many years? 17 years, 18 years, 17 years, 18, 19 years. Bhai sahab. From minimum 17 to maximum 19 years answer I have got.
Toh bhai,
who is motivating your mother in the morning to make breakfast every day? Same job, thankless job. After receiving the breakfast, you will not say thanks internally from your heart. Why this thankless job your mother is able to do from 17 to 19 years without getting bored, without getting demotivated? Yaar, one extra minute I can also sleep. Na? That feeling is not coming in the mother's mind. Who is motivating her every day? Someone is coming up, ki, come on, you will make breakfast, come on. Someone motivated? Nahin. No. No. That is what happens. For the longer journeys, motivation can never work, bhai sir. Ha, when you are feeling low, before the NEET examination, NEET 2023 came. Let us say tomorrow is NEET 2023 and today you are doubting your capacity. Today you are doubting your capability. Ki, sir, I am feeling like I am forgetting everything. Tomorrow is my exam, sir. I don't feel I will be doing good in that examination, sir. What should I do? There I will motivate you. There everyone will come together, the whole team will come together and motivate you. Ki, beta, don't worry. Whole year you have prepared. How you will not clear the exam? If you will not clear, no one else will be able to clear. Honestly, we have worked. NCERT line by line you have seen, no one have seen that much. In the class you have seen those lines from NCERT that people don't even know exist. Material after material we have solved, so many tests you have written. Even if you have not done as good as you thought you can do, still it is enough to qualify this examination. You just go and do your best. This is what I can say one day before. Why, sir? Because next day the job you are doing is not a boring job. That is writing the actual NEET examination, your selection year NEET examination. You need motivation. You need the chemical called as dopamine. Dopamine is the chemical which is synthesized in the body, which will give you a feeling of well-being also and a feeling of doing the work more profoundly. So the people who say, na, ki I'm feeling a little depressed or something, I'm feeling demotivated, that means dopamine content is decreasing. This can be increased in two ways. Number one, food habits. Fruits you eat more, it will increase automatically. That's for every chemical in the body. Second is by listening to these motivational lectures and all. But you tell me this thing, this feeling of euphoria, correct? This feeling of euphoria, this feeling of dopamine, this chemical will remain for 8 months in your body. Kya? Can it remain in your body for 8 months? The body will not degrade this chemical. This much to biology, you know, yaar, metabolic pathways, you know very well. So why are you worried about motivation? Why don't you learn from your own mother who is doing the same job from 17 to 19 years? You don't even have to do for 17 months. You have to do for only 8 months. So now tell me, what is the reason that your mother is able to do this consistently? Consistency there, dedication there, whatever you need to give to your academics. I feel very bad when people say to their mother, Mummy, you remain quiet here, you don't know about this examination. True. She don't know about this exam, true. Probably. But she knows about life much better than you can ever know. And she knows you 9 months more than you know yourself. Learn from her, listen from her. See how your mother is doing that job. Sir, why not from father? I'll tell you the reason. Because father gets the salary for the work. Motivation is there. Some motivation, external motivation is there. Every month he gets the salary. Whenever the salary gets credited in the account, next day going to the office, he might feel a little more energetic. But become like your mother. So much responsibility she carries on her shoulder without any motivation. It is because of just one reason. And that one reason is habit. This is the thing which is missing in you. You are searching your answer in motivation and the answer lies in the habit. Chala, chadda habit you have generated since the beginning of your schooling. Not completing your homework in time. Not reading in the class carefully. losing the focus in the middle of the class for some activity, because mobile you are using. So right now WhatsApp is also going on in the middle. Some idiots are doing WhatsApp, also talking to each other. Dekho, dekho, sir is saying this. Some will record the video. Some will go on Instagram and check also. So much focus you are losing. You are knowingly doing it. It's not like subconsciously it is happening. You can delete WhatsApp also. You can delete Instagram also, but you will not do. You will do the drama, sir, then how will I get information? I know you will do that. But at the heart, you know very well ki deviations you have created for yourself. You are not changing your old habits, but you want to change your result. And because the habits are bad, marks are less, understanding is less. Because if I teach something today and you revise that by the end of the class, because after the end of the class, na, energy is there. But what people do after the end of the class, they take rest. Even though they don't need rest, guarantee I'm telling you, after the last class, you don't need rest, but you took the rest. You took rest. Because of that, momentum broke. Successful people keep on reading till the time momentum is there. They don't count the number of hours, how much they are reading. They keep on reading, and when they feel very bored, then they change a little bit. They change the subject also sometimes, just subject. They don't stop reading also sometimes. I'm not saying that read this much and become bilkul crazy. Nahin. But when after the class, you know you have to complete your notes, and lunch can wait for half an hour, then why don't you revise the notes immediately after the class also, and then in the evening also? If that will happen, understanding increases. Understanding increase, marks will increase. Marks will increase, motivation will increase. Your only motivation which can make you study for 8 months are consistent weekly marks. Every week, the day you start getting 660, 670 consistently, na, after seeing your marks, your heart will say, I will study more. What a feeling is there of getting 670, 680. You will 100% study more. Only one thing can motivate you. Words are the last thing which can give you selection. Because if motivation can give you selection, we will not be teaching in the class. Baba we will become. मित्रों, समाज में हमको खुद को साबित करना है. नहीं यार, वी आर नॉट पॉलिटिशियंस, वी आर नॉट बाबा, वी आर नॉट टेलिंग यू द मीनिंग ऑफ लाइफ. वी डोंट नो दैट मच. वी जस्ट नो बेसिक फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री, बायोलॉजी. वी नो अवर स्टूडेंट्स बिकॉज वी हैव टॉट सो मेनी स्टूडेंट्स. वी नो व्हाट दे फील बिकॉज वी ऑल्सो लिव्ड एट योर स्टेज. We also felt this thing, that the toughest thing to do in the life is to study. Because immediate reward will not come in the studies. In the studies, you will get failed 100 times, then one time you will get the reward. But what people do, they fail 50 times and then they quit. Then they ask for motivation. Generate habit. Sir, how to generate habit? Habit is generated by forcing yourself to do the thing that you don't like to do. Going to the gym. I always say, that's why we named our material also gym. The reason we named our material gym was this only. Gym, Goshalites year-long material, gym. Why? It is like gym, mental gym. When you'll go first time to the gym, na, morning, people pay the fees of the gym, then they don't go to the gym. Have you listened this thing several times? Ki sir, I paid the money for the gym, or some uncle, some maybe your father also might have paid the money for the gym, but did not go to the gym completely. So, bhai sahab, this is not the problem of only academics. This is in general the problem. Then there are bodybuilders also who love going to gym. Sir, why are they going to gym? Because they see the result. They see the six-pack abs, eight-pack abs. They see their shoulders building up. They see the biceps increasing. They go to the gym more and more. But when the result will not come, na, bhai sahab, when the result will be less, the motivation will also be less. And the habit is the reason for it. So those people who can maintain for 1 to 2 months in gym and 2 weeks in academics, that much, that making a good body is tougher than clearing the NEET examination. Getting six-pack abs, not natural, by going to gym. If you are fat like me, for example, you are like my physique, and if I have to make a six-pack abs, more work will be required and less work is required for clearing this examination. NEET examination. So that's why I'm saying 2 months in the gym, if you go, you get result. When you get result, you feel like going more and more. एडिक्शन इट बिकम्स भाई. तो मेक योर गोल योर एडिक्शन. एन एडिक्शन इज नॉट मेड ऑन द फर्स्ट डे. चड्डा एडिक्शन ऑल्सो भाई साहब. सम पीपल स्टार्ट स्मोकिंग ऑल्सो ऑन द फर्स्ट डे. दे विल नॉट बी एडिक्टेड टू द स्मोकिंग बट सी देयर डेडिकेशन लेवल. स्टूपिडिटी इज देयर बट डेडिकेशन लेवल देखो. दे विल smoke for one month, 1 year, 2 years, then suddenly one day they realize that they are addicted. We will not smoke. We will not do drugs. We are not going to be so stupid. We will be addicted to our academics. It will be painful. We will cough in the middle. We'll feel very large pain. Why I have to wake up every day? Till when will I be able to tolerate this? You will tolerate. You will tolerate because only you can tolerate. Remaining people are sitting and sleeping in their houses. They are decreasing for competition for you. So when no one is working, you work. Feel is not coming. Sir, I cannot work for two hours. Don't work for 2 hours. Half an hour work, but work. Maintain that consistency. Let the tire rolling. Don't stop the wheel. The wheel should keep on rolling. Even slow, sometimes fast, but keep on reading. Keep on revising notes every day. Keep on doing the material every day. A day will come suddenly. Whatever you are doing, whatever was the pain once, will become your gain, will become your habit. And once it becomes the habit, na bhai sahab, then you will motivate us. You will motivate us. Answers will come so rapidly in the class, not in the next class, that teacher will feel even more happy and will teach more and more content. More energy they will give in the class also. So you are our source of motivation, not the other way around. Understood, bhai sir? Because we need motivation, because whatever we are doing for 1.5 hour, for that moment we are doing, for you we are doing. So if you motivate us before the class, we'll be doing that same class with more energy. But you have to do something every day. It's not easy, I understand, because I have done that. It's very tough. But then, for easy thing, you did not join the long term. Na? Dreams are also big, na yaar. Some chinna dreams you have not seen. Na? When the dreams are big, work will be bigger. Understood? So convert your pain into your habit. Take it more and more. Clear, bhai? Suffering you have to do. Either suffer in the installments throughout your life. Either suffer in the installment throughout your life. Or suffer once. And then enjoy in the installment throughout your life. Choice is yours. And for that, no motivation will work. Like right now, after this session, you will be, "Arey, sir, I'm highly motivated." Nahi, useless. If you feel motivated after my class, maha useless. But if you sit after my class and revise the notes because I said to revise, that means you are going in the right direction. You are going in the direction of making your habit. To learn from the lady because of whom you are right now here listening to me. Your first teacher, she knows the importance of habit. She might not be able to use the right words which I use to explain you the same thing. But she knows what you have to do. So learn by observing her. How she wakes up every day? 5 o'clock you're waking up, she will also wake up. Even though she don't have to, but she will. Getting by? Understood? Similarly, even though you don't feel like waking up in the morning and study, still wake up and study because it's your job. And once after 1 month, 2 months, you start getting good marks because of good habits, it becomes your addiction. After that, toh, yeah, books will be removed in front of you. Then also you will run behind the book and study. Clear, bhai sir? Bilkul yaar. Understood? Mother and father, these two are the only people whose importance will be told by outside people to you. You will not realize yourself. Understood? But that is the different story altogether. Today our story was very simple. Motivation versus habit. What we need? Motivation. Bakwas. Ha! If you are liger, you are going for the fight. Before the fight, slap yourself hard. Motivation will come. Adrenaline rush will come. Dopamine content will go high. But you are not going for a fight. It's an 8 months long battle. Motivation is not enough. Habit required. Munchy habit required. Discipline required. Clear, bhai sahab? Understood? Bilkul. Arre, wake up in the morning. I'm telling you one more thing. Try to do that. Wake up in the morning and take a 10 minutes brisk walking, fast walking or running. 10 minutes every day. Then start reading. Clear, bhai? Then you will realize, why the people said ki healthy mind remain in the healthy body. Then you will realize. People wake up without taking bath, they start studying. Nahi yaar, chala chadda discipline. You know what you have to do. That willpower required. And don't use your willpower here and there, it will get wasted. For a small, small thing, don't use it. Use for only one thing. Kya? Sitting for the studies. Then after that, you are able to study, getting distracted, something like that. None of your concern. Your work is only to sit and study. Distraction coming, not coming, it's okay. That is not in your hand. Marks are not in your hand. Your performance is not in your hand. But your work, your initiation of the work, that is in your hand. Focus on initiation. Focus on starting the study. You feel tired, start it. Wherever you will sleep, you sleep. No problem. But you start at least. Starting only you have to focus. Just remember these words of mine. Focus on starting the work. You will be surprised to see your brain and your body will 100% give full commitment in that. Clear, bhai? Chaliye. So now we are starting with. Write down. Next chapter. Some basic concepts of chemistry. Some basic concepts of chemistry. Then, bhai, shall we start? Enough time given, bhai. More than this time, don't expect motivation now. Whatever I have to tell, I have told once. You want to make notes, you can make the notes. It's on YouTube, you can check again. Clear? Now, new topic started. Consistent, we have to study for 7 to 8 days. After that, test is there. Done, bhai? So, some basic concepts of chemistry. So, the first thing we have to study here are the laws of chemical combinations. In short, we are going to see the laws of chemical combination. My expectation is that after reading this, you will once read the NCERT also. For this topic, make sure that you read the NCERT. First chapter, junior inter, first chapter, some basic concepts of chemistry. Search laws of chemical combination and read this topic from NCERT once. Don't take it lightly. It's easy topic, very elementary topic, but don't take it lightly. Chaliye. Number one, law of conservation of mass. So what is law of conservation of mass? Note down. It means that the mass of reactant will be equal to the mass of product. Very elementary knowledge, very simple concept. Ki whatever is the mass of reactant will be equal to mass of product. That means no extra weight will be generated during the reaction and no weight will be lost during the reaction. If you have a closed container, the mass will remain constant. Let's see the example. Ki 1 gram H2 and 2 gram O2 react in a closed vessel to form water with 40% efficiency. Find mass of the vessel at the end of reaction. Find the mass of the vessel at the end of reaction. Now, if you see the question properly by the end of the year, it might look like a very tough question, but very simple, elementary question it is. Ki there is a container. In that container, you have 1 gram hydrogen and 2 gram oxygen. Then some reaction happened, some efficiency given. At the end of the reaction, what will be the mass of the vessel? To apply this concept, ki bhai sahab, mass will never change in a closed container. In a closed container, from where the mass will come? For example, initial mass is 1 gram plus 2 gram. Initial mass is 3 gram. Ab yaar, why the mass will increase or why the mass will decrease? Think once.
Why the mass will increase or decrease? If 1 gram hydrogen, 2 gram O2 taken, so total mass 3 gram, na? So mass of reactant is 3 gram. Now whatever the reaction happened, product is also in the same container, na? Hello? So if I remove my hand and join on my head, old bond broken, new bond formed. So kya my weight will change? My weight will change? No. Sir, previously also reactant was having same mass. Now old bond broken, new bond formed. Hand removed and put here. So mass to same only, na? Veliginda, shape changes, molecule changes, but mass remain conserved. So what is the answer? Initial mass equal to final mass equal to 3 gram. Say bhai, is the concept of conservation of mass clear to us? Simple. Hello. Law of conservation of mass clear. Great. So going to the next page. It's very elementary, very basic thing. I'm not directly starting with mole. I'm starting with as basic as possible according to your needs syllabus. Below this level, not possible. This is the starting level. Chaliye. Next. Number two, law of definite proportion. Law of definite proportion. So percentage composition of an element in a compound is constant. Percentage composition of an element in a compound is constant, independent of source, preparation, etc. Does not matter where is the source, how much, which preparation method you have used, how much mass you have taken, also. It's independent of everything. Percent composition of an element in a compound is a constant. Let us see with example what I want to say. Let's take the example of manchinilu, H2O. Manchinilu, H2O. Hydrogen mass. Hydrogen molar mass. So molar mass of hydrogen is 1 gram. Molar mass of hydrogen is 1 gram. And there are 2 hydrogen atoms. So the mass will come out to be molar mass to be 2 gram. Say bhai, clear? Molar mass of hydrogen atom 1 gram. So for H2, the mass is 2 gram. Problem unda? Great. O, 16 gram is the molar mass. For oxygen atom, molar mass is 16 gram. So for this total H2O, 2 plus 16, 18 gram is the total molar mass of H2O. Say bhai, I don't think problem should be here. Great. So percentage of hydrogen will be, how you find any percentage? Sir, marks obtained upon total marks into 100. So what is the percentage of hydrogen? Weight of hydrogen by total weight into 100. So what is the weight of hydrogen atom? Total weight of hydrogen atom. Sir, rain 2 gram. 2 gram is the total weight of hydrogen and total weight of H2O. Weight of hydrogen 2 gram. And total weight of H2O 18 gram. Into 100. So 11.1% coming. Check bhai. Check. Any problem anyone has? Because now I will give you a question. Now I will check your concept clarity. This is the basic mathematics we can do. Again, we will do the same thing in the next class also. But I will check your concept clarity now by asking you one question. Question is, find percentage of hydrogen in 360 gram of water. find the percentage of hydrogen in 360 grams of water. Surya, Suhas, bilkul, no problem at all, correct. Now, those who are thinking, sir, what is the answer? Bhai, read the law of definite proportion, yaar. Percentage composition of an element is independent of anything, yaar. Hey, hey. Sir, 360 gram given, sir. So, 360 gram given, so. Arre, bhaiya, I said percentage composition of element in a compound is a. Arre, is a. Constant. Which constant are you finding 100 times, yaar? So what's the answer, sir?
Arre bhaiya, answer is 11.1%, bhai. Say clear or not.
Sir, but 360 gram, where should I use?
Don't use. Why you have to use?
Everything is not meant for use. Base is strong. Concept is strong. That is required. Is the idea clear, bhai? People get confused in elementary things only. Mole concept, so half the people can solve the question still. Clear? Achha, if I change the data, ki find the percentage of hydrogen in 18 gram H2O, what's the answer? 11.1. Now some people will say, ki sir, here to 18 gram water taken, sir, here 360 gram taken. Arre bhaiya, you keep on changing the amount, you change the source, you change the preparation method, does not matter. Yaar, parwa le du. Percentage composition of an element of a compound, element in a compound is a constant. Hello? Is this properly settled in the head? For 7 moles of water, for 7 moles of water, what is the percentage composition of oxygen? 7 moles of water, tell me the percentage composition of oxygen in water. 7 moles of water, percentage composition of oxygen. Surya, bilkul bakwas answer. Ashwak, correct. Vikram, correct. Priyanka, correct. Venkat, correct. Gagandeep, kya kar rahe hai? 934 correct, Gayatri correct, Abhiram correct, Khaja bilkul nahi, kya pata nahi, what are you trying to do? Such a simple question is there on such a simple concept. You can understand. See bhai, I asked you the question. What I asked you? Let's see what I asked. I asked, find percentage of oxygen in 7 moles H2O. Such a simple concept was there. Now, you could have done like this also. Okay, sir, weight of oxygen 16 grams, 16 by 18 into 100. But you did not do. Easy thing I'm telling you. Bhai, jab 11.1% is hydrogen. Arre yaar, 11.1% hydrogen, to how much oxygen, bhai? Chichi. Such a simple question in blunder you are doing wrong. Chee, chee. This answer also not giving correct. Now tell, Viliginda. Arre chamka yaar. Shining like a setting sun, like a pearl upon the ocean. Concept clear? Oye, hello. Concept clear or not clear, bhai? Sir, but 7 mole given, sir. Arre, jo given, whatever given, I don't care what given. Percentage composition does not change. And once you know the percentage of hydrogen, to oxygen also you know na yaar. You can find like this as well. Ki weight of oxygen by weight of water into 100. This also you can do. Nothing wrong. So then what should I take the weight of oxygen? Same, 16. And weight of water, 18 into 100. This will come at 8.9%. Then doubt will come. Ki sir, here to 18 gram you have taken, sir. But here to 7 moles given, na? Tell me one thing. 7 mole given, 360 gram given, whatever given. Percentage composition will come constant or not? Tell me this much. It will come constant or not? It will come constant or not? Yes, bilkul. If it is coming constant, तो whether I use 7 mole and find the answer, or I use 360 gram and find the answer, or I use 18 gram, 16 gram, 2 gram and find the answer, answer will be same only. So why should I confuse myself by using the given data? I can use the given data, same answer will come. No problem in that. But the method will be lengthy, yaar. Plus, I have common sense, I have brain. So why will I waste my time on using the method, which is longer method? When I know that percentage composition will come same only, whether I take 3 gram, 30 gram or 3 kg, does not matter. So I will find for one H2O, na? And whatever I will get for one H2O, I will apply the same answer for everyone. Because that's the common sense. That's why we are using the law of definite proportion for NEET examination. Say, bhai, any problem, any samasya, any peeda up to here. Getting the flavor of stoichiometry little bit. Brain opening. This is a very good chapter for opening brain. Your conventional thinking, mugging will not work here. But understanding will be awesome. Kya re sir? Kya baat hai? Yehi to. So basic common sense things are there. Let's carry on to the next law. Next law. Number 3. Law of multiple proportion. Law of multiple proportion. So when a fixed mass of an element combined with other element to form two or more compounds, then the mass of other element required is in simple whole number ratio. When a fixed mass of an element combined with other element to form two or more compounds, then the mass of other element required is in the simple whole number ratio. This is the definition which you have to write in the notebook. Now, how to get marks in the examination? Let's understand. Law of multiple proportion applicable when there are only not more, not less, only two elements. You cannot have more than two also not allowed. You should have only two element, then only you can apply the law of multiple proportion. Let's see. Law of multiple proportion is applicable when one, carbon and oxygen forms CO and CO2. Number two, carbon, oxygen and sulfur forms CO2, CS2 and SO2. Hydrogen and sulfur forms H2S. And number four, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen form CH3CHO and CH3CH2OH. Haan ji bhai, law of multiple proportion is applicable when? See the definition and tell me. See carefully all the four options. More than one choice correct answer. More than one choice. There can be two answers also. Think. One and three only coming. Ashwak Singh only first. Theek hai. One and three. Khaja Singh one. Gagandeep and all. Suchita also. One and three. Shamita one. Let's see. Number one, no one is saying 2, no one is saying 3, because there are 1, 2, 3 element. So only 2 element kawali. For multiple proportion, only 2 element required. Correct, bhai sahab? So answer cannot be 2, answer cannot be 4. This much everyone is clear. Out of 1 and 3, some people are saying 1, some people are saying both 1 and 3. That means they all accept answer 1 correct. Now 3 is debatable. Let's see. When a fixed mass of an element combined with other element. So rendu element required. So rendu elements here also. Carbon, oxygen. Rendu elements here also. Hydrogen, sulfur. To form two or more compounds. Here how many compound, beta? One compound only, sir. Here how many compounds, bhai sahab? Two compounds, sir. So, sir, according to definition, third is also wrong. First is the only correct answer. Say, bhai, is the concept clear? Are you realizing from such a stupid topic also good MCQs can be made? Don't take any line of NCERT lightly. People sometimes expect ki sir will suddenly jump into mole concept and teach me mole only. What's the guarantee that question will come from mole and not from this part of NCERT? This is also in the syllabus. Check the NEET syllabus, you will find. Clear, bhai? And you will not believe. Which exam NEET has never asked question from this topic, pata hai? JEE Advanced asked this year. JEE Advanced 2022 paper 1C. This year, JEE Advanced asked the question from law of multiple proportion, bhai. The toughest exam of the country. NEET is the third toughest exam in this level. The toughest exam of the senior inter level in the country. JEE Advanced, conducted by IIT Bombay, I think, this year. They ask the question of law of multiple proportion, yeah. So if they can ask, be prepared, NEET can also ask. Because now they will realize, this topic is also there, we forgot. Then they will make question from here. Are we prepared for that question, bhai? Are we able to identify where we can apply law of multiple proportion carefully? Any problem, samasya, pida? Any problem, any samasya, any pida here? So I'm going ahead then. I'm going ahead now. Great. Number 3 was done. Number 4. Gay-Lussac's law of combining volumes. Gay-Lussac's law of combining volumes. So what happens in this law is very simple. Ki gases react and produce in whole number ratio of their volumes. Or no need to write whole number also. In the ratio of their volumes. Whole number, this is our wish now. We can make it whole number or we can make it fractional also. That is our wish. Stoichiometry is our wish. So gases react and produce in the ratio of their volume. Let's try to understand. So SO2 is a gas. React with half O2, which is a gas. Forms SO3, which is a gas. So the number, see, listen carefully now. The number before the compound or element, the number before the compound, or the number before the element in the equation. Let's say here nothing written, so 1. This is called stoichiometry. This is called stoichiometry. Biliginda? The number written before the reactant and the number written before the product is called stoichiometry. Like this is half. This half is also stoichiometry. This one is also stoichiometry. Check, bhai. Okay. This one, this half, this one, these are stoichiometry.
So here, this 1 liter react with half liter, 1 liter SO2 react with half liter O2 to produce, oh bhai, hello, how much liter SO3? To produce how much liter SO3? 1 liter. Are you yes or no? Why you are giving me the feeling of Dora the Explorer?
So 1 liter SO2 react with half liter O2 to form 1 liter SO3. This is Gay-Lussac's law of combining volume. Ki bhai, whenever gases are there, na, if P and T are same, pressure and temperature are same, so if the gases are there, so their stoichiometry can be represented as volume also directly. Directly, you can write, instead of 1 SO2 reacting, you can say 1 liter reacting also. Instead of saying 1 SO2 reacted with half O2 or 1 mole reacted with half mole, instead of that, we can also say 1 liter react with half liter also for gases. Say, bhai, am I clear? Gay-Lussac's law of combining volume clear? This we will use a lot. This law is used a lot for solving the numericals in the stoichiometry. Clear? Next week only, not this week, but we'll use a lot. Done, bhai. Then, number 5. Avogadro's law, which says that volume proportional to moles for gases at same temperature and pressure. So V and N are proportional. This thing will be dealt in the physics track 2, I think within the next class. Boyle's law started today. Manish Pandey sir started Boyle's law. Great. So within 2-3 laws, you will get Avogadro's law also. This will come in the states of matter in chemistry. And right now in the expansion of gases, you might be reading this also very soon. Is the idea clear, bhai? So shall we move on to the next topic? First topic, law of chemical combinations, over, according to NCERT. Done? Chalo, one small thing. Out of NCERT, one very small thing I'm telling you, just for the safety sake. 3 elements combine. Getting 3 elements combined, 3 products generally. The law we apply here is law of reciprocal proportion. Not in NCERT, so we will not be reading this in detail. This was in older NCERT. In old NCERT, this was there. So risk is there if the paper setter is having old NCERT. And if they make a question from here, we must know how to identify reciprocal proportion also. Okay, bhai? People teach this a lot also here because they don't update according to the new trend. NCERT changes, syllabus changes, people don't adapt to that. That's why people are teaching this also. Maybe you might have read it somewhere. Done, bhai? But understand, this is out of NCERT. Be very clear. So like carbon, sulfur, oxygen. Carbon, oxygen together, they will react to form, let's say, CO2. Sulfur, oxygen, SO2. Carbon, sulfur, CH2. So this way, 3 element and 3 compounds. How bits will come? Same like multiple proportion, bhai. For example, law of reciprocal proportion is applicable when? Answer will be second option. 3 element, 3 compound, reciprocal proportion. 2 element, 2 or more compound, multiple proportion. Easy. Vilikinda? Are hello? Understood how the question can come? But again, out of NCERT, more than this time, I will not give it to it. Enough. Beyond NCERT, I don't like to. I feel very bad when I go beyond NCERT. So we'll not go beyond that. So we are coming back. Chaliye. So law of reciprocal proportion, we have seen superficially how to identify. So now let's carry on with our topic. Now our topic is एटॉमिक मास एंड मॉलिक्यूलर मास. एटॉमिक मास एंड मॉलिक्यूलर मास. व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एटॉमिक मास हियर? लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड दिस पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस पार्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक इज गोइंग टू डिसाइड हाउ योर अपकमिंग लेक्चर्स आर गोइंग टू गो. सो एटॉमिक मास इज मास ऑफ वन वकटी वन एटम. भैया वन वन नॉट वन मोल नॉट वन मोल जस्ट वन. तो मास ऑफ वन एटम इज एटॉमिक मास. सिमिलरली मॉलिक्यूलर मास इज मास ऑफ वन मॉलिक्यूल वन जस्ट वन नॉट वन मोल वन जस्ट वन मॉलिक्यूल मास इज मॉलिक्यूलर मास. क्लियर भाई? एटॉमिक एंड द मॉलिक्यूलर मासेस दे आर रिप्रेजेंटेड इन AMU or U or Dalton's. Biology people, they love Dalton's. Otherwise, we use AMU or U. AMU is atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. And U is called unified mass. This U is called unified mass. DA is Dalton. So atomic mass unit AMU. And 1 AMU is equals to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 grams. And this value is equals to 1 upon 6 into 10 to the power 23. Bhai, see, this conversion is very easy. 1.66 10 to the power minus 24 gram is okay. Normal conversion. But this thing magically comes 1 upon Na. Don't say it 1 upon Na, but it is approximately equal to 1 upon 6 into 10 to the power 23. And this conversion we will use a lot for our calculations. And this is equal to 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 27 kg. One question came in your paper also, last paper. Remember, proton mass is 1 AMU and 1.66 10 to the power minus 27 kg. Answer key got changed. Clear? That answer key is both 1 and 3. Say bhai, clear? 1 AMU is how much? This thing you have to write 10 times in the notebook, then only you will be 100% sure that you don't forget it. Don't be overconfident. Don't think, sir, I already remember, sir, or I can remember by single reading. Don't act like a genius right now. Understood? Always study like an idiot and then you will get the marks like a genius. So study like an idiot and write it 10 times. Don't trust your brain. It will forget. So 1 AMU is this much gram. Chale, let's see the example now. Hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, phosphorus. Then we can put lithium. So hydrogen atom mass is 1 AMU. This mass numbers you remember, right? Mass number you remember. Oh, hello. Mass number to you remember na for first 20 element. In case you don't remember, write first 20 elements. Mass number also in notebook. You cannot refer again and again to the books. So from the periodic table of NCERT, you can find periodic table where the mass is given. So first 20 element masses you can write. So hydrogen 1 AMU, carbon 12 AMU, nitrogen 14 AMU. Focus upon AMU here. Don't focus upon number. Number you have to remember. Mass you have to remember. Focus on the unit. These are which masses we are writing? Which mass we are writing, beta? Which mass are we writing? Atomic mass. Mass of vakati atom. Are one atom only, yaar. So sulfur will be 32 AMU. Phosphorus will be 31 AMU. Lithium is 7 AMU. AMU, atomic mass unit. Say bhai, any problem, samasya pita. Tell bhai, is anyone having problem in this also? Is anyone having problem in this also? Great. Now, molecular mass we are finding H2O, CO2, O2, H2SO4, CaCO3, N2O. Let's see. So what is the mass of H2O? Everyone focus on the board. In case you are doing it for the first time, to extra focus. Hydrogen atom mass is 1. Hydrogen atom 1. But there are 2 hydrogen atoms. And oxygen atom mass is 16. So 16 plus 2, 18. Unit will be AMU for molecular mass. Mass of 1 molecule of H2O. 1. One chala 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 chinna molecule, very very small molecule, extremely small molecule, one molecule only, 18 AMU. Carbon mass, carbon 12, oxygen 16 into 2, 32. 32 and 12, 44 AMU. Oxygen atom mass 16, there are 2 oxygen atoms, so 32 AMU. H2SO4, hydrogen mass 1, but there are 2 atoms of hydrogen. Sulfur mass 32. And oxygen mass 16 into 4, 64. So 64 plus 32 plus 2 will come 98 AMU. Then, N2O you will find, CaCO3 I am telling you, find N2O, I am telling you CaCO3. So calcium 40, carbon 12, oxygen 16 into 3. So 48 plus 12, 60, 60 plus 40, 100, so 100 AMU. Twarga twarga find the mass of N2O molecule, molecular mass of N2O. Molecular mass of N2O, Ashwag correct, Gayatri correct. Priyanka correct, Gagandeep correct, Redmi correct, Sanjay correct, Oppo correct, Rishal correct, Vikram correct. Some are doing calculation mistake in this also. Chichi. How can you do calculation mistake in this also here? Chi. Yuck. See the calculation again, bhai. 44 AMU, yaar, 44 AMU. Here also calculation mistake. See, below this level you will go kya? Sixth class student can do this by seeing the data from here. Sixth class student can do. Ki 2 Chintu and 1 Pintu, what is the total mass? Chintu is 14 AMU. Pintu is O. 16 AMU. So Pintu, 16 AMU, Chintu, 14 AMU, Rendu, Chintu, Vakati, Pintu, total mass. But third, fourth class student do this question, yeah. Their basic addition question this is. Chi, yuck, lack. Say, bhai, problem unda? Oh, hello. Problem unda? Atomic mass, molecular mass, what's the unit we use? What is the unit we use? AMU. So what is the atomic mass of sodium? Atomic mass of sodium, Na. Sodium atomic mass. Chapandi everyone. Unit, unit are important. Abey Lalluram, unit important here. Units are important. Number you give 5000 also, I don't have any problem here. Unit should be correct. So 23 AMU. 23 AMU, atomic mass unit. Fasek. AMU you have to use, AMU. Done. Chaliye. Now, find molecular mass of glucose. C6H12O6. Chaliye, padapad, twarga twarga, start. Molecular mass of glucose C6H12O6. Correct, bhai. Correct, correct, correct. Bilkul correct. 100% correct. Correct. Now you are good student, suddenly using the units also, bus. Small, small things you do here. Yeah. Teacher become happy, very happy. I'm feeling so happy. I will go to Himalayas now. I'll become a sannyasi now.
My dream has become reality. Everyone using EMU. I can't hold my tears now.
आ गया Xiaomi के 180 चपेट गए गद बट हो चुका है 180 तो व्हाट्स द आंसर 180 AMU एटॉमिक मास यूनिट लेट्स सी कार्बन 12 बट देयर आर 6 कार्बन मास 12 हाइड्रोजन मास 1 बट देयर आर 12 हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन मास 16 बट देयर आर 6 ऑक्सीजन So total 180 AMU is the mass. Done, bhai. Chali, one more question. Find molecular mass of glucose in grams. In grams. Find molecular mass of glucose in grams. Don't forget what you have learned just now. Don't become chadda again. Don't make the wrong habit. Ke, sir, gram given, sir, what should I do? Don't do anything. Bas, Varshi has done. Varshi has done. Yaar, Varshi, sun to leti. Yaar, listen at least to me. Varshi, why you have to become idiot suddenly? Vikram, why? Vivo, why? Redmi Note 9 Pro, why you are becoming idiots? When the molecular mass here was 180 AMU, you are a magician, you will make it 180 gram. Chapet. Nalayak. What did I ask you? Molecular mass. Here also I asked you molecular mass. Here the answer came 180 AMU. Here suddenly 180 AMU magically will become 180 gram. iPhone is so idiot. He just now again answered 180 gram. हे प्रभु उठा ले बेटा उठा ले प्रभु उठा ले तो फ्रॉम एक्सट्रीम हैप्पीनेस टू एक्सट्रीम फ्रस्ट्रेशन जर्नी आई हैव सीन जस्ट विद इन 2 मिनट्स छी 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 आय हाय यक यक यू कैन नॉट स्टिक टू योर थ्योरी आल्सो ना सो मच लैक ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस इज देयर एवरी क्वेश्चन न्यू थ्योरी यू अप्लाई एवरी क्वेश्चन यू अप्लाई न्यू थ्योरी One small confusion I gave, very small confusion I gave, and everything shattered. Whatever we learned in this whole slide, whatever we learned in this question, everything shattered by one word. How weak your whole life is living on, how weak concepts you are living here. Pathetic situation. But sir, you gave gram na, sir, then what to do? Go bang your head on the wall, or maybe knee. Let the brain come in the place. Tell me now, what is the molecular mass of glucose? What is the molecular mass of glucose? Everyone. Oye, tell the molecular mass of glucose. Everyone. 180 AMU. 180 AMU. Ab kya magically AMU I will cut and gram I will put. Kya? My weight is 80 kg. What is my weight in tons? So 80 tons. My weight is 80 kg. What is my weight in milligram? 80 milligram. Now I will fly. The brain, little bit brain unda. Once use, once think what you have done. Your weight is 30 gram, 30 kg. Represent in gram, how many gram? 30 kg weight means how many gram? 30 kg weight means how many gram? 30 kg means how many gram? Try everyone. Reply torga torga. 30 kg means how many gram? 30 kg means 30,000 gram or 30 gram only? 30 kg means 30 gram. Are 180 AMU is 180 gram, na? So 30 kg also 30 gram. I'm feeling like that one meme was there, na? When the Pakistan dropped the catch, and he was standing like this. नालायक कहेंगे तो व्हाट डिड यू डू सर आई कन्वर्टेड केजी इनटू ग्राम हाउ डिड यू कन्वर्ट केजी इनटू ग्राम हाउ डिड यू गॉट हाउ डिड यू गेट 30,000 ग्राम हाउ यू गॉट 30,000 मल्टीप्लाई बाय 1,000 ना अरे यार यस ऑन हो यार, बिकॉज 1 kg 1000 ग्राम, करेक्ट, बिकॉज 1 kg is 1000 ग्राम. एग्री? एग्रीड. हेलो, नाउ यू हैव टू कन्वर्ट 180 amu इनटू ग्राम. दैट इज व्हाई आई सेड अंकल आंटी, दैट इज व्हाई आई सेड राइट इट 10 times, बिकॉज दिस इज व्हाट यू विल नेवर यूज इन योर लाइफ. नो ओवर कॉन्फिडेंस. Write it 10 times that it will stick in the brain. When it will stick in the brain, then only the idea will come. Na, you will not get the idea of this thing until you write it several times. This is there in the brain somewhere and lost within one slide gone. So, bhai, how to convert AMU into gram? Let us see. So, AMU converted into gram as 180 AMU. I am converting to gram. Multiply with 1/6 × 10^23 gram. अरे यार, 1 AMU is this much gram, 1 AMU this much gram, 1 AMU this much gram. अरे 1 AMU this much gram, अरे 1 AMU this much gram, अरे 1 AMU this much gram. Yes or no? तो 1 AMU this much gram means 180 AMU is 180 into this much gram. Hey भगवान, yes or no? Correct? तो भैया 6 × 3 = 18, 30. So 30 × 10^-23 gram. That is 3 × 10^-22 gram. See, one step only, yaar. Say, did you understand now? Understood? Gagandeep, NA will not come, bhai. Devta, Prabhu, Prabhu, shama prarthi hai apan. We are shama prarthi. Please forgive us. I did not use NA anywhere here for this reason only, that you don't use NA. So don't use NA, bhai. There is no Avogadro number here. It is looking like Avogadro number, but this is not Avogadro number, bhai. By mistake also, don't do this mistake, bhai. Some I will get heart attack. Then who will teach track one leftover part, yaar? Half chapter I will leave. Tell, bhai. Will this click in the exam? Let's see. That depends upon if you will do 50 question like this, same to same, 50 models. Will then it click? Will it click then? Bata Xiaomi 11. Will it click? Yes. So bas, practice. Practice makes a human perfect. This was said by Divya ma'am. Remember, practice makes a human perfect. Dekh lo tum, man, woman, both. Practice makes a human perfect. Let's do one more question, bhai. Let's do one more question so that it settles in your brain. Find एटॉमिक मास. चलो एटॉमिक मास नहीं, आई विल राइट इन बेटर वे. फाइंड मास ऑफ 1 carbon atom इन ग्राम्स. भाई प्लीज गिव द करेक्ट आंसर, प्लीज यार, प्लीज, आई इंसिस्ट. पार्टी आई विल गिव यू, ऑनलाइन पार्टी. गिव मी द करेक्ट आंसर. फाइंड द मास ऑफ 1 carbon atom इन ग्राम्स. बस आ गया 2 ग्राम. आई एम नॉट आस्किंग द वेट ऑफ योर ब्रेन बेटा, गिव मी आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन. 2 ग्राम. आई एम नॉट आस्किंग वेट ऑफ योर ब्रेन, दैट विल ऑल्सो इवेपोरेट. दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर आई एम आस्किंग. नाउ एवरीवन गिविंग करेक्ट आंसर. चलो ठीक है नायक, अगेन आई एम नॉट आस्किंग वेट ऑफ योर ब्रेन. आई नो इट इज 2 ग्राम. Your brain weight. This 1 carbon atom weight I was asking actually. This is less than your brain's weight, by the way. That's the hint. Remaining are correct. Now Nayak will tell me what is the mass of 1 carbon atom, bhai. Nayak will tell me what's the mass of 1 carbon atom. Nayak, mass of 1 carbon atom, 12. Kya 12 kilometers? 12 picometer? 12 angstrom, 12 centimeter, AMU. Badiya. So, it is 12 AMU, correct? Tell me how 12 AMU became 6 gram. Just few moments back, 12 AMU became 12 gram. Sir, you said wrong. So now 12 AMU, 2 gram. Bhai. So how to convert? How to convert? This I will get 12 into 1 by 6 into 10 to the power 23 grams. Done? Are you correct? Oye, hello. Oye. Correct. So 6 twos are 12. So 2 into 10 to the power minus 23 gram. Veliginda. One more, yaar. Minor heart attack I got. Two wrong answer came. One more. Find mass of. Achha, I'll play the game. Okay, I'll play small, little bit game I will play. Okay? Find the mass of two molecules of H2O. A little bit I'm playing. Chala playing, little bit. Find the mass of two molecules of H2O. Two molecules. Please use your brain. Please try. Use your brain. You will get the answer. Don't worry. Just try. Open mind, ekdam. Free mind. Try to do the question. Rendu molecules. What is one molecule weight of H2O unit? Then two molecules, how much? And that you have to represent in grams. Final answer you have to give in grams. Suhas, correct. Just convert this into grams also. Chaliye, thank God. Till now the heart is okay. So some people will intentionally answer wrong. Okay, this person is yells a lot in the class. Heart attack. Yeah, wrong answer. I know. But this much weak I am not. I was joking. I will not die because of your wrong answer. You are not the first one to give the wrong answer. Chali bhai, let's carry on. Find the mass of two molecule of H2O. So by this time all the answers are correct. Brilliant, no problem at all. So bhai, one H2O, what is the mass? 18 AMU, we all found. So for two H2O, the mass will be 36 AMU. Am I correct? Up to here, any problem? I don't think should be there. Because you answered correct only by this time. Now convert into grams. To converting into grams, multiply with 1 upon 6 into 10 to the power 23. So 6 are 36. So 6 into 10 to the power minus 23 grams. Say bhai, problem unda. Done bhai. So one more question, last. Find mass of 10 CaCO3 molecules in AMU and grams. So two different answers you have to give me. Give me one answer in AMU and then you give the next answer in grams. So make sure that you use the units properly. So very simple funda. CaCO3 100 AMU is the molecular mass. So one CaCO3 100 AMU. So this implies 10 CaCO3, it will be 1000 AMU. Correct na yaar? Are 100, one CaCO3 100 AMU. So 10 for that 10 times 1000 AMU. Now this 1000 AMU is one of the answer. Now we have to convert this into grams. So 1000 AMU into grams will be 1000 into. Now I know some people will do 1 by 6 into dash bar 23, which is not wrong, which is correct. This is correct. But if we act smartly and we save our calculation by knowing this, ki 1 upon 6 into 10 to the power 23, 1 upon 6 into 10 to the power 23 is 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24. So our calculations will be saved. Isn't it? This is also the conversion factor. Are same only na? Are 1 by 6 or 0.166 same only. So 1 by 6 into 10 to the power 23 is 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24. So this I will multiply. It will come 1.66 into 10 to the power minus 24 and 3 minus 21 grams. Say bhai, any problem samasya pida? Two answers came. Xiaomi 11. Now it will click or now also it will not click? In the exam, now will it click or now also not click? May click, bus 5 I have given, 10 you will do, 15 question enough. Done, bhai. So right now, exercise will not be enough. Next class, after next class, only the exercise will be enough for you. So today, your small homework is there that you have to complete. Number one, write the formula 10 times, AMU. Okay? Write that conversion 10 times and write the first 20 element masses. This much can we do? This much can we do? This is the third last class of online, I think. Second last class. Friday today, na? Friday. Tomorrow is the last online class. Not online, sorry. YouTube live. Not online. YouTube live. I think you got heart attack. Maybe not online class. YouTube live. YouTube live last is on Saturday. Clear? Sunday the groups will be created and Monday onwards the class will happen on the app. So what you thought? Only I will get the heart attack. Yeah. So once it will come in the app, then the study material will also get uploaded in the app only for your practice as well. Extra material. Meanwhile, I have talked to the people here also. They are saying that courier can be sent. Just that at one center for, like, for example, you live in a place 500 kilometers away. So they are in one place, which is maybe 60, 70, 80 kilometers away from your house. There only 4 or 5 materials can be sent together rather than individual sending. Okay, bhai? That is what they were saying. But once you can also talk, he said we can give.